and welcome to episode 3 of Dragons TV. Tonight we are back in the den as we welcome the Billingham Stars for the return game of this weekend's doubleheader. Last night the Dragons lost 7-2 to the Stars, so the Dragons will be looking for the victory to try and claw back those 2 points. Don't forget you can follow all our social media channels that can be found here. And hit that subscribe button for exclusive content.
At the weekend, the Dragons faced the Billingham Stars in their first league games of the season. First, we took the trip up to the northeast for the first leg. Dragons were in good spirits as they arrived as they looked ahead to the game. Before we knew it, warm-up was underway and it was netminder Jace Gledhill who took to the crease first, followed by tonight's starting netminder Matt Croyle. After a successful 15-minute warm-up, it was nearly time for puck drop. The Billingham rink then welcomed your Aspray Chester Deeside Dragons. When both teams were on the ice, it was a line-up ready for the national anthem. Then, after a group huddle and team handshakes, it was to centre ice for puck drop. After 3 periods, it was a final score of 7-2. It was a hard-fought game by the Dragons, but unfortunately it was a loss in their first league game of the season. Dragons' goals came from Brody Jessen and Ross Kennedy. And with one goal, it was Ross Kennedy who picked up the MVP for the Dragons. And that was it. Dragons took their lap of honour. It was back to Wales for the return leg. Monday, we were back in the den for our first home league game. Warm-up was well underway and the team began to gain their focus. Croyle saved 41 of 48 shots last night, so he'll be bringing his A game again, this time on home ice. Before puck drop, our new mascot Flame made an appearance and already became a big hit with fans, including Ian Speedy from our title sponsor Aspray Chester. Due to having a short bench, Dragons management brought in none other than Jodie Alderson-Smith, Team GB women's captain. It was go time. The crowd went wild as your Aspray Chester Deeside Dragons took to the ice. And the teams lined up for the national anthem. Was dropped for the first period, Dragons versus Stars. It was Stars who found the back of the net first after just 4 minutes, followed by their second a few minutes later, closely followed by their third. Dragons kept on pushing, but the Stars netminder was on top form. But finally, just after halfway through the first, Captain James Parsons got the puck over the line, assisted by our guest Jodie Alderson-Smith. Out we went for period two. Just a couple of minutes into the second, it was Ross Kennedy who scored, assisted by Alex Parry. Then it was Ross Kennedy again with the equaliser, assisted by Matt Wainwright and Brody Jessen. But the Stars came right back with their fourth goal. After the puck drop for the third period, Dragons went full steam ahead. Just under 3 minutes into the third, Stars got their fifth goal, closely followed by their sixth and seventh. Dragons didn't give up easily, but with just 1 minute remaining in the game, the Stars got their eighth goal. And that was the game. Final score, Dragons 3, Stars 8. First, MVP for the Stars was number 15, Chris Sykes. And MVP for the Dragons was our guest from Team Great Britain Women's, Jodie Alderson-Smith. The weekend stats are as follows. Stars versus Dragons, the score was 7-2. Shots on goal, Stars 31, Dragons 48. Dragons versus Stars, the score was 3-8. Shots on goal, 27 to Dragons, 26 to Stars. After the game, I caught up with assistant coach Matt Compton and tonight's guest, Jodie Alderson-Smith.
Okay, so I'm here with Jodie Alderson-Smith. How are you doing?
Good, thank you.
Good, good. Congratulations on MVP.
Thank you.
How are you feeling after tonight's game?
I mean, I didn't plan to wake up and play a game today, but Mike asked me if I wanted to try and get a loan to play, and here I am. Yeah. But it was a good game.
Did you connect well with the Dragons team?
Yeah, they all welcomed me in really well and looked after me on the ice. I think I took a hit and they all got my back, so it was good.
So it's been a really hard-fought game tonight. How does being in this league compare to your hockey overall?
So obviously for women's, it's a completely different game. It's women's hockey isn't physical as like the men's game, but I play in the NHL for Coventry. It's still a fast game, but stepping up a league is a lot more faster. The guys think a bit quicker. They make passes like 100 mile an hour, and you just got to react a lot faster and keep your head up because you just don't know when you're going to get hit next.
Yeah. Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, I loved it. It was a really good game.
Awesome. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
So I'm here with assistant coach Matt Compton. How are you doing?
Could be better after the weekend, to be honest.
Yeah. I mean, full weekend done now. We are finally into the season, albeit not the best games. Are you happy to get started?
Yes, happy to get started, and obviously the start of the end of last season as well. We managed to get a pre-season in, plenty of good practices in as well, which obviously again, previous season we didn't manage to do, but obviously disappointed with the weekend's results.
Yeah. We were short-benched this weekend and lost the talent of Charlie Spridgen last night and James Parsons tonight. Do you feel confident that we would have got the win if we would have had a full team?
Definitely. You know, there's guys missing for various reasons as well, other players. So, I think with the full bench, you know, without suspensions, injuries, and guys got other stuff going on, we definitely could have pushed that to the end. Losing Stepper as well, massive for us. Yeah. So our captain, you know, big part of the team, especially off the ice as well. So that was a big blow for us.
And obviously, we'd like to send our best wishes to Charlie and James. Are you feeling confident then going into next weekend?
Yeah, we're getting two or three guys back for next weekend, so we'll have a good practice Wednesday. You know, if confident, we'll get some points on the board next weekend. Big weekend for us.
Yeah.
So yeah, confident. Yeah.
All right, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
And that's it for this week. This weekend, the Aspray Chester Deeside Dragons travel north again to face the Hull Jets on Saturday and the return game on Sunday as we welcome the Whitley Warriors to the Den. Thank you very much for joining us. Thank you.